Up next, let's hear it for Jessica Dubé and Brian Savage.
I grew up in a little village in Quebec. Skating is a big thing in Quebec. Like, everyone is pretty much born with skates on. It's what we do.
In 2006, at Torino's Olympic Winter Games, Jessica Dubé and her partner Bryce Davison made the figure skating world sit up and take notice. They're in a groove. A year later, they faced disaster.
We were doing a side-by-side spin and got too close.
Oh! Oh, no!
Oh, my God.
I thought my nose was broken because it hurt. I saw Bryce's face, and I was like, there's something wrong. Like, it's not just my nose that's broken.
In surgery, Jessica received 83 stitches, her facial laceration 3 layers deep.
It's a horrific accident fans of figure skating feared would one day happen. It did, and it involved 2 Canadians.
When I was at the hospital and they told me my face was going to be fine, I was like, okay, I'm good to go. Can I get back on the ice? I told Bryce, this is something we have to do. I was right back at it 8 days later doing the spin. It's the first thing we did when we got back on the ice. A year after my accident, we were 3rd at Worlds. I guess that makes me who I am today.
In Sudbury in the late 70s, the Canadian hockey dream burned bright inside young Brian Savage. In 94 at Lillehammer, Norway, he realized that dream.
The Olympics were the highlight of my hockey career. I was a part of something bigger than just a hockey team. I was part of a nation. Those moments there, you never forget the rest of your life.
Fresh from the unexpected Olympic silver, Brian took up residency as a Montreal Canadian.
Patrick Savage!
In November of 1999, we were playing L.A. in L.A. Had my head down, was taking a slap shot. An L.A. player hit me.
See Savage? I said, yes, boss, huh?
The hit left Brian with 3 crushed vertebrae, writhing in pain.
My wife was 5 months pregnant with our first child. I thought hockey was everything up to that point. And after that experience, that changed.
Brian healed quickly and returned in 4 months, a changed man.
I still loved the game. I still competed and worked hard at trying to be the best hockey player, but it wasn't everything in my life. It's family. Its future is about other people, not Brian Savage.
Another chance, they score!
Brian remained a great NHL goal scorer for 7 more seasons. But in 06, in Philadelphia, he came to a life-altering crossroad.
My brother Mike was diagnosed with a tumor in his esophagus. He had surgery to remove the tumor in his whole esophagus. And a month later, the doctor pulled us aside and he said it has spread all over his body and, you know, I'm not sure how much time he has. I had to make some decisions. Either play hockey or... or be with my brother. So it wasn't a tough decision. I retired from the game. He passed away on December 19th of that year. Those 3 months, 4 months I had with my brother, really cherished them.
Push in my hands.
Yes. We're much alike, him and I. I think it might be good for us here.
Here to introduce our next performance is Brian's neighbor and dear friend.
Canada, it is your old pal Brett Michaels here to wish my friends Brian and Jessica the best as they skate to Every Rose Has Its Thorn. The 3 of us, we are fighters. We have fought back from some very serious injuries in our life. And I just want to tell you thank you so much for skating for charity. And more than being great skaters, both of you are great people. Rock on, my friends. Rock on, Canada.
We both lie silent and still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we feel miles apart inside. Was it something I said or something I did? Did my words not come out right? Though I tried not to hurt you, though I tried, but I guess that's why they say every rose has its thorn. Just like every night has its dawn. Just like every cowboy sings a sad song. Every rose has its thorn. Just like every night has its dawn. Just like every cowboy sings a sad song. Every rose has its thorn.
Heaven sent. Jessica Dubé, Brian Savage. Saw the moment right at the start. A little pat from Jessica. I was like the way we were in Vancouver. Tremendous. Kurt Browning, what'd you think?
I'm still thinking. You know what happened out there? It started, I thought I knew what was going to happen. I've seen it run through in practice. And then Jessica turned to you and smiled, and your face changed. Mm-hmm. It was, instead of getting nervous in competition, you got better. Your crossovers were strong. You were sensitive to your partner. It was solid. And every cowboy maybe does sing a sad, sad song, but tonight, it was a sad song with a happy ending. I was so impressed. Really well.
Jamie Soler.
I completely agree with Kurt. I thought, like everybody tonight, you're just lighting it up for a slow song that was really emotional and very touching. Jessica, of course, is like our little kitten in figure skating, that cute little face, and you held her perfectly. And I know that that was probably a very emotional skate for you, and your brother was so looking down on you and so proud of you. And I know Brett Michaels back home is also very proud of skating that number to his song so well.
PJ.
They deserve just to be able to skate after watching that pack, which, again, as a skater, it's so hard to do for us guys. We're not used to that. Just do that number after watching that little preview, kudos. And, you know, Brian's nickname, Brian would score about 30 goals a year, but he got about 29 of them in October. So the rest, he got the nickname Mr. October. Good thing this skate was in October.
I always say, though, PJ, teams make the playoffs based on that first month. We forget that sometimes. So it was great to have a guy that could get out of the gate the way you can, and you did it again tonight. Incredible. Jessica skating for Multiple Sclerosis Society of Canada, and Brian is skating on behalf of 10 Rainbows, and in particular, the Megan's Wings program honoring his niece. Judges, may we have your scores, beginning with Kurt Browning.
You can. It's a 5-5.
Jamie Soler.
Sorry, I was tough because I know there's more. 5-4.
PJ Stock.
5-5.
You can boo if you want to. If you want to help Jessica and Brian be safe, you have to vote for them right here. Remember, no phones this year. All online. Everybody gets a vote, but it's easy to earn more votes. For details or to cast your vote, go to cbc.ca/battle. Now, once again, time to check out the ING Direct leaderboard. And as you look at the standings, you can start to think about the power you have as a viewer and your ability to save somebody from going into the bottom two next week. And you can see Marcy and Mike are right now on the bubble. Way back at the start of the night, we got those two 16.8s. It's been pretty tough to top those initial performances. Remember, the two pairs who received the fewest votes of the evening, they're in the skate-off next week. So we need you to help out, because the judges next week are sending somebody home.